I'll be completely real and say I don't understand how Man City have won that game. 2-1, we've beaten Borussia Dortmund. It's one of the craziest games of football, at least ends to a game of football I've seen from City in such a long time. Without a striker, sometimes, you know, City would either lose or win with a kind of level predictability. What we've seen today is crazy. We've seen a Vincent Kompany-esque, you know, against Leicester, John Stones finish. We've seen Haaland's goal. It's surreal. The finish is surreal. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you expect me to say in this video about that finish, but it's a very, very good goal. It's a world-class finish. It's as simple as that. But we'll talk about those goals further on in the video. Obviously, make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Tons of Man City content coming out. And let me know in the comments down below, did you see us winning that game, 70 minutes in? Firstly, we have to talk about Borussia Dortmund. Edin Terzic has got a side that are very well drilled. They are humble. They work hard off the ball. Their fans were absolutely incredible tonight. And actually, in the first sort of 50, 60 minutes, how many sides are going to be, you know, keeping City at bay? You know, keeping us, preventing us from scoring, preventing us from even getting registering a shot on target in the first 40 odd minutes. And it really is down to a level of organisational ability. Süle, Hummels, two centre-backs that I've always revered, especially Hummels in particular. The keeper today, backup keeper, did really well, Emre Can. And then, the boy, Jude Bellingham, some good challenges on, obviously, his Aston Villa rival in Jack Grealish today. We'll talk about him later in the video as well. But Jude Bellingham was a cut above the rest. This kid is... I don't know what to say. I'm so glad he plays in a different league, so I don't have to watch him play for anyone else than the Man City in the Premier League. I hope he joins Man City. I hope there's a world that can happen. He is what football's all about. He's humble. He works hard. He is so naturally talented at winning the ball, working hard off the ball. He is what football is all about. Don't let, you know, fans on social media get, you know, social media hype, VAR, £100 million transfers get in the way of what football's all about. And Jude Bellingham is a kid that loves the game, works hard, is athletic. And then on top of that, a bit like Steven Gerrard back in the day, he's got so much quality. And I have to start the video just talking about Jude Bellingham because today he showed it. Maybe not even as good as he was a couple of years against us in the Champions League. But he was very, very good tonight. And he is a world-class midfielder. I sort of stumbled saying it. I think he's world-class and he's that good. I honestly have to say it. But yeah, let's be completely real. 45 minutes, City struggled. And the lineup that went out tonight, you know, I was really excited about Jack Grealish, Haaland linking up. They have no chemistry. Maybe as lads they do, but on a footballing level, that's going to have to be worked on. I'm really worried about Jack Grealish. I want you to let me know what you think in the comments down below, but I'm really worried about him. Maybe it's dramatic saying that. We've just beaten Dortmund 2-1 at home. It's still early in the season, but there are transitions into clubs. Sometimes it takes 2 years. Sometimes it takes a year. More often than not, he should be settled in by now, and he's not doing the right things, in my opinion. Lots of opportunities given to him. Lots of one-on-ones. He's cutting in. And someone like Süle, who's a big lad, a bit slow, a bit immobile, he's getting across, covering. Even Meunier, you know, not a top right back really, you know, a good solid international pro. Of course, he's been at various big clubs, but these guys had him in his back pocket really. Jack Grealish really struggled today to get past these lot. You know, there are moments where he's cutting in 3-4 times doing the same thing, not working. And look, in the group stages, you don't want to be too critical, you don't want to be too reactive. Again, City just beating Dortmund 2-1, it's a great result for any City fan to say that. But if we're going to be looking to win the Champions League, get to semi-finals, you know, win cups, the FA Cup, the League Cup, these are big competitions against big sides. And Jack Grealish hasn't done enough so far this season to warrant playing in the big games and starting and to make a difference in big games. That's just the truth. And I don't want to be gassing too much. He's a very special footballer. But there are moments where he's not cutting in on his left. You know, he's cutting in on his right. He's not shifting it back on his left. He's not drilling things across the box. He's trying too many things. If you get one or two shots blocked, that's fine. But when it's approaching 3 or 4 in the first half, for me, he's becoming someone that's a bit of a liability in terms of, you know, the front three for City have to all provide. You know, it's as simple as that. And he isn't providing. That's just the reality. If I'm being too reactionary, let me know. I think there's a lot of room for improvement. I think he can get there. But for me, Jack Grealish is a big reason why we looked a bit toothless in that first half, Haaland isolated. If you have pace around him, even Julian Alvarez, if he was to play as a kind of winger in this side in the first half, I think you beat a man. Even Cancelo on his left foot. Cancelo absolutely had the beating of Meunier at points, had some unbelievable techers going down the left flank. More than Jack Grealish. And it's almost like back in the day, you'd have a fullback. The fullback would overlap. You'd give it to the fullback. The winger would overlap. You know, and the winger would be the most aggressive, you know, forward-thinking, attacking player. Our kind of left flank with Jack Grealish and Cancelo actually is Cancelo gives it to Jack Grealish to hold for him. And then Jack Grealish gives it back to Cancelo to be the creative player who's a fullback. Now, Cancelo's a fantastic player, but I have to go there with it just because I think for £100 million, it's beginning to look like a struggle of a transfer. That's just the reality. We'll talk about the positives. We've beaten Dortmund again, but I have to talk about it because it's just of interest to me that Jack Grealish, big start for him tonight. I'm not sure he lived up to it, to be completely real. Second half, different side. You know, we see Phil Foden comes on. He's direct. He hits things first time on his left foot. You know, him as a left winger, he can do things first time on his left foot. The issue with Mahrez and Grealish, they both have to cut in. They both have to take an extra touch. They're both trying to whip things in and with a bit of dead weight, and it's kind of curling in. Sometimes you just want to hit it flat, you know, along the ground, first time, around the corner. You can't do that with inverted wingers. And Phil Foden today was absolutely incredible. But still, for 25 minutes, you know, obviously Dortmund hold us. And then they score a fantastic goal. Great header from Jude Bellingham. Marco Reus was a problem all night. And it's a very, very, it's a very good header. He's timed it perfectly. He's gambled. He's done everything right. And it's a beautiful finish. And really, Dortmund would be looking at themselves thinking, we should have won this 1-0. As a side that probably want to have a little bit of a run in the Champions League, maybe be dark horses on their day, you know, beating City, you know, gives them that opportunity to maybe come first in the group, which would be so important to them. And then they kind of, you know, they succumb to what is, I can only describe as utter football magic. I mean, what we've seen from John Stones is Vincent Kompany against Leicester 2019. He doesn't do that often, but he smashed it almost from a harder angle than Vincent Kompany, maybe a bit closer, but a little bit of a tighter angle. And it's an unbelievable finish. Could the keeper have done better? I'm not sure. You've got to always give benefit of the doubt to the attacker, in my opinion, but it's an unbelievable goal. And then we see what is an unreal... I mean, we've seen Cancelo do this cross into Haaland now a few times, outside of the boot. I don't know if on a footballing level, when you're on the pitch looking at it, does it add more spin to the ball? Does it make it a bit faster? I'm not sure, but it's kind of a... It's just a different kind of cross to defend. It kind of dips quicker. And then Haaland, first time on his left foot, back across the goal, in the air. It is... Oh. It's a moment of silence. You know, people are giving up moments of silences in this country for all sorts of reasons recently. I want to give it a moment of silence almost in this video. You know, stand with me if you want to give it a moment of silence. But that finish is world class. It really is. It's Zlatan. You know, Zlatan used to do that, you know, Inter Milan kind of time, Juventus time, early 2000s. Any kind of finish will do. Scorpion kicks and weird angles and his bodies are all sorts. What a fantastic player this guy is. Haaland, I think Haaland's the best striker in world football. I'm going to go there. I think... That finish is surreal. Harry Kane's dropped off. Lewandowski's looking a little bit old. Struggled against Bayern Munich last night. That finish, City are looking at the best striker in world football playing for us, getting us out of trouble. Now, long story short, that will help us in the Champions League. It will give us confidence that Haaland can do this against... He's scored in every Champions League game he's played for City. 26 and 21 games now for Haaland, which is an unbelievable record. And ultimately, City need to learn how to get out of trouble. And if we're 1-0 down at home in the quarterfinals of a Champions League draw, semi-finals, final even, if we were to be in a final, we now know that Haaland has the ability to score an unbelievable range of goals. He's so dangerous. Defenders shit themselves at a moment's notice. And he is the difference maker. What a player. I'm still in awe of this guy. And it's only 7-8 games into the season. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. 2-1 for Man City on the end of the night. It's an unbelievable result for us. But we go into the Wolves game. Probably a little bit more important. You know, keep up pace with Arsenal in particular. Spurs, if they were to get a win this weekend as well. Let me know what you think in the comments down below about the result. Crazy game of football.